Several thousand years back, Suras and Asuras came together for the biggest joint venture or partnership in the world, which was Sagar Manthan. No one could have individually, single-handedly accomplished that humongous task of churning the entire sea to bring out pearls from the sea, to bring out hidden perils, hidden treasures which came out of this churning of sea. And yes, one point was amply proved, was absolutely clear, that unity is strength. 1 + 1 is not 2, it is 11. And yes, a dream come true for the professionals today. A dream which has been seen by professionals of all three professional bodies since ever. This has been in discussion. Since I was doing my chartered accountancy, my company secretary and my CMA, these discussions were on since that time. But in the month of August 2021, yes, the dream for all the professionals to come together and service their clients unanimously has come true. And yes, the regulation with respect to multidisciplinary partnership firms have been introduced in the law. I'll tell you a brief background. So what are you talking about? You're looking so excited. So but what are you talking about? I'll tell you a brief background, a brief history about these three professions, CA, CS and CMA. Yes, three apex professional bodies of the country which are regulating the three apex professions, which is accounting, costing for CMAs and secretarial bookkeeping for CS professionals. So yes, three areas where these were working in. Now, the internal regulations which were there in these three professional bodies restricted to have combined partnerships of CAs with CMAs or CAs with CS, CS with CMA. Those combined partnerships were restricted. The areas were well demarcated and they were expected to work in their respective areas in silos. They were not expected to merge together. They were not expected to create joint ventures. They were not allowed to create partnership firms in which a CA, CS and CMA were partners. They were not allowed to do this. But yes, now after opening up of economy, after opening up of the world at large, the dream of Vasudhaiv Kutumbakam has been realized, then why not our professions? So now CS, CS and CMA, all three institute have opened doors for the other institutes and other professionals, and now it is possible for a CMA firm to have a CA partner or a CS partner or an advocate partner or an actuary partner or an engineer partner or an architect partner, so that a wholesome lot of service can be given to a particular client. One stop destination can be created for a client where all the solutions are there for the client under one roof. Otherwise, earlier what used to happen is that a client used to go to a CA to, you know, maybe get its accounts done and audit done. He has to visit a CMA firm to get its cost audit signed and verified, or maybe get its internal audit done. And he has to visit a company secretary office to get its secretarial books audited or maintained. So a client had to visit three offices for getting the work done, which is related to one unified thing, which is financial statements and accounts and, you know, the gamut of financial services. But now, with opening of multidisciplinary partnership firms, client will be required to only visit one office and all three professionals will be there at that particular office. Not only these three professionals, guys, but advocates, actuaries, engineers, all will be unified under one roof with advent of multidisciplinary partnership firm. Yes, a dream which was seen 20 years back, 10 years back, in time immemorial, these discussions have been on that, you know, you should permit CMA partnership firms to have CA partners, CS partners. You should permit CA partnership firms to have CMA partners. This dream was seen long, long back. Now it has been realized. So yes, I can confidently say, achhe din aa gaye hain. What are the benefit that this kind of intermingling will entail for the students, for the CMA students? So guys, the benefit that will be entailed for CMA students is with respect to their trainings. when CMA firms will allow chartered accountants to be their partners. When chartered accountancy firm will have CMAs as their partners, there'll definitely be exchange of information, exchange of knowledge, exchange of infrastructure, exchange of intellectual property. And yes, the best benefit that is going to be derived is by the students who are getting their training done from such firms, which are multidisciplinary firms, which have CS also working in the same firm, CA also working in the same firm, CMA, advocates also working in the same firm. The most benefit lot will be students at large. Their training avenues will increase, their quality of training will increase, and their future will be golden. They'll be able to venture into whatever they want to do in life in future. So maybe a CMA student can venture into, say, secretarial bookkeeping in the future. A CMA student can venture into the normal bookkeeping, the accounts work in future. So after getting all those skills from the respective professional, CMA student's horizon will be increased. So that is the best part and beautiful part about these multidisciplinary partnership firms. So yes, notification is in front of you. It has been entered into on 13th of August 2021. Whereby Ministry of Corporate Affairs have allowed the draft regulations of the Cost and Works Accountants Regulation 1959 to be amended, and the amended regulations will be termed as Cost and Works Accountants Amendment Regulation 2021. And what is the amendment which has been introduced in these earlier amendments? So these were the earlier amendments. The amendments which has been introduced is that after regulation 111C, the following shall be inserted. So another clause 111D shall be inserted after clause 111C. And what is that clause 111D? Let us read. A member in practice may form multidisciplinary firm with a member of other professional bodies as prescribed under regulation 111B. So this is an insertion, section 11, regulation 111D, and regulation 111D permits the a member of CMA to be associated with members of other professional bodies, which are specifically given in regulation 111B. I'll take you through 111B and 111C shortly. In accordance with the regulating guidelines of council for functioning and regulation of such multidisciplinary partnership firms, let me tell you, all my earlier students who are into practice, all my earlier students who are into their own individual partnership firms or individual sole proprietorship firms are definitely going to benefit from this particular regulation a lot. Now let me show you the regulation of Institute of Cost and Works Accountants Act. Okay, this is the 1959 regulation which is there, and this is the much coveted regulation, which is 111C. Okay, so 111C is dealing with members of professional bodies for partnership for the purpose of entering into partnership under clause 4 and part 5 1 of first schedule of the act. A person shall be a member of any professional body, namely Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. So a person who is an Institute of Chartered Accountants of India member, he can form a partner in a CMA firm. Company secretary can be a partner with a CMA. Advocate, member of Bar Council. Engineer, who's member of Institute of Engineers. Architect, who's a member of Institute of Architects. Actuary, who's member of Institute of Actuaries. Then any other professional body whose qualification is related to cost accountancy are recognized in council under subsection 2 of section 38. So guys, there are certain foreign bodies also whose association have been approved by the Institute of Cost Accountants of India. And now after this regulation, there will be another regulation, which is 111D, which will permit all these professionals to be associated with CMAs in practice. So yes, amazing news, a piece of information that is relevant for the CMA students, because their future is going to be bright, as well as for my past CMA students who are into their practices now. An amazing initiative which is undertaken by the Institute of Cost Accountants of India and all the three professional bodies, not only our institute but the other institutes as well. So guys, what I did was I went through the website of Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, and Institute of Chartered Accountants of India have given certain FAQs with respect to this partnership firms. So yes, they have within their FAQs have another question, which the question is whether the cost accountant can become partner in a multidisciplinary partnership, CAs in partner. So whether a cost accountant can become a partner in CA firm as well, just like CMA partnership firm can have a CA partner. Similarly, CA partnership firm can also have a CMA partner subject to this regulation. So what is the regulation? As per section 2.1 of the Cost and Works Accountants Act, cost accountant means a person who is member of the institute. And guys, this is the definition of member which is given to be in practice. You have to have a certificate of practice and you should have a practice of cost accountancy, etc. All these things are relevant. Now it says that Clause 4 of Part 1 of First Schedule to Cost and Works Accountants Act, professional misconduct with respect to cost accountant in practice. So that first schedule doesn't permit you to become a to have a CMA who is forming partnership with a CA. It doesn't permit you. But now what happens is, and the cost accountant practice shall be deemed to be guilty of professional misconduct. This was the earlier regulation which is there, okay? Now, the earlier regulation is that cost accountant practice shall be deemed to be guilty of professional misconduct if he enters into partnership with such person who is member of another professional body, okay? So, he'll be deemed to be a person with who will be guilty of professional misconduct, okay? But now, after advent of regulation 11111C and 11D, 111D, what is that regulation? 11C, Cost and Works Accountant Regulation, membership of professional body in partnership. For the purpose of entering into partnership under clauses 4 and 5 of part 1 of first schedule to the act, a person shall be member of any of the professional bodies. Chartered accountancy also being one of the members which is permitted to be a partner of a CMA. So now, as per section 6.1 of the Cost and Works Accountant Act, no member of the institute shall be entitled to practice whether in India or elsewhere unless he is obtained from counsel a certificate of practice. Certificate of practice is required to be obtained. Hence, MDP, CAs in practice shall be permitted to enter into partnership with members of Institute of Cost Accountants of India. So the erstwhile regulation is no more in practice now. In practice, the new regulation, which is 101C, and I've just made you read 111D. So 111C and 111D are the relevant regulations now. And now CMAs can also become partners in CA partnership firms, and vice versa also. CMA partnership firms can have CAs as their partners. So yes, amazing initiative by both the institutes, Institute of Chartered Accountants of India and Institute of Cost Accountants of India. I would definitely want to congratulate both the institutes for taking this superb initiative. Why only these two? I mean, Company Secretary Institute has also taken this same initiative. So yes, an amazing news for all the practicing cost accountants, all the practicing chartered accountants. Now you are free to have your brothers and sisters from another profession. So to say, you know, brother from another mother. So you can have brother from another mother. You can have a bro code with other professionals as well. And you can form a multidisciplinary partnership firm, which was a dream for so many years. Now realize, now I can proudly say that yes, now all three professions will integrate together in a very, very fruitful manner. And this will result into a amazing, amazing future for all of us. So yes, with that short note, with that small information for all of you, all the very best and happy studying, and also happy practicing.